Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to 60 Seconds Reatomized. Thank you, everyone, who keeps on liking and watching these videos, man. You guys and gals are loving this game, and I am too, honestly. It's a fantastic game. I decided I'm going to try a little bit of a challenge. I'm not exactly sure how the challenges work, so I'm just going to go in order here. Survival. Yeah, we're going to go survival here. Let's see. We have got Scout's Honor, which I think is just Timmy by himself. Responsible Parenting, Survival of the Fittest, Shelter Alone. Oh, wait, no, that is that one it? I think Shelter Alone is the one with Timmy by himself. A Woman and Her Dog, Final Countdown, Scout's Honor. Yeah, you know what? Let's start with Shelter Alone. Shelter Alone, the McDoodles set out for a family expedition, but make the classic mistake of forgetting their son. Little Timmy has the shelter all to himself, but a pair of bandits have their eye on the seemingly abandoned McDoodle bunker. Can Timmy protect his home until his parents return? Protect shelter over 30 days. Timmy only, no expeditions. Axe is disabled. Reward toy skin for the bullets, the flashlight, or the cart. Sure. You know what? This might be a train wreck, but sure. Let's try it. Our first challenge here, yes, med kits are very cool. So we don't get the axe. It's Timmy by himself. We can't go for expeditions. And we got to survive for 30 days. So that means that obviously we're gonna have to protect the food supply. We're also going to make sure that we have to have some form of deterrent for raiders. Day one, alone in the shelter, finally alone. So many possibilities, so much space. Thankfully, Ted and Dolores left some supplies behind. They took the axe, so this rifle will have to do if anyone tries to make trouble. And we're going to have to try to make it last, Tim, because kind of wild. Day one, it's not easy to be calm in these circumstances. Hopefully we'll be finding our own peace for the... Yeah, okay. So it looks like this is going to be a challenge where I am going to have to only feed him. If we have one can of soup, we can only feed him, and we have to last for 30 days. Essentially once every... just over 9 days, maybe? No, that's not true. It's whatever. Hey, too, it's not hard to be. Timmy's still good. Yeah, I mean, I think that we're just going to have to ration everything. Day two, a polite knock at the door. Oh no, it's turned loud. Try and break the door. Yeah, all right. So, yeah, definitely want to make sure that they can't get in immediately. As long as Timmy doesn't break the gun. And he broke the gun. Well done, Tim. Good job. We were able to hit one of them with a lucky ricochet that scared them off. As he was running away holding his buttocks, he cried over his shoulder, "We'll be back! We're gonna get you, you little jerk!" One of them even lost his shoes. Yikes, that escalated quickly. And drama, and the dang rifle is jammed. Perhaps we need a plan. Timmy's been talking about nothing other than water. You should drink soon. Well, Timmy, you're just gonna have to wait. Okay, so on day three, I don't know if this is scripted or not, but that seems pretty ridiculous that we lost the gun this early on. Day four, fond memories. The only thing we need, Timmy's in terrible shape. We need to give him water now. Okay, so I think that I have to give him water. Let's see if he makes one more day. Today we met a bunch of people dressed like Halloween doctor outfits. They plan on, yeah, sure, give him water. Why not? Okay, Timmy's not dead, but he's probably really, really thirsty. All right, Tilly, clean water. Timmy's in terrible shape. We need to give him water now. Yeah, all right. All right, all right, all right. So we'll give Timmy water. Day five. Last time, the bandits threatened to light up this dump with torches to finish the job, so we have our own torches to fight fire. Is there anything we can use against them? Use the bug spray, I guess. And hopefully they drop a gun or something? Maybe? Maybe? They didn't, and we... Mission Blowtorch was a success. Once we heard the door open, we unloaded the whole can of the nearest torch, causing quite a fire explosion. The bandits did not enjoy our explosion welcome and scattered, shouting something about flamethrowers. Too bad, they would probably be back once they put out their flaming hats. He's no longer thirsty. He's still not hungry, and we don't have a med kit, so... I don't know how we're supposed to acquire items in this one. I also don't know how random all these events are. Day seven, bravely ignoring our symptoms. Yeah, well, I mean, Timmy should eat something. No, Tim, you gotta wait. Day seven, every new smell attacks our nose. A little shelter isn't much we can miss. Try to check that hole out and see what the source of that smell is. This is either good or bad. This can sometimes get you a can of food. This can also sometimes make you sick. And we got a can of food. Good. Good, good, good. We looked in the hole, fearing something might come out of the claws, fangs, or other mutated sharp body parts. Nothing. Instead, we found a dead rat who was trying to break into the can. Okay, yeah. So we got the plus one food here. They ate those pretty packages with a ribbon on it waiting outside. The note reads, "For my brave little scout, love mom. Is it safe to open?" No. No. Dolores doesn't know. Dolores, they forgot Tim. There's no reason why that's... No, use your head, Timmy. Come on now. I'm not going to play into their scheme like that. That's a terrible idea. Day 9. Yeah, right. It must have been to trap some of those bandits. Shove that love where the sun don't shine, Mom. Give him water now. Diet needs food. It's today or never. Dehydration and starvation. Let's make it to day 10, Tim. Okay, he's not dead. I'm waiting for the end to come up. Okay, so now we can feed him and let him drink. Yeah. Okay. All right, so we give Tim full everything. You got there, Timmy. Day 10, something needs to be done before the bandits return. We know for a fact at least one of them is barefoot. If something sharp enough was to be scattered on the ground, we could really make them feel the pain. All right, that's how we deter them with the checkerboard. So we're one third of the way there. Good job, Tim. Day 11, the checker pieces were set in place. As predicted, at least one of the invaders was barefoot, and soon terrible screams could be heard outside. Why is that worded so weird? Seems like good old American checkers are much worse than that new Danish invention Legos. Yeah, right. The pain, we'll be back. You know we're in there, you're all alone. Shout out before leaving. Wait, what? His diet needs food is today or never. What are you talking about? You just ate, Tim. Day 11, one of the cupboards sheltered, but Shady pulled out a secret door. We have no flashlight or rifle, so let's see where it leads, Tim. Hopefully to an axe. Or to nothing. All right. Day 12, some things are better left untouched and unknown. Whatever's behind that door, I have to stay there. We also stack some furniture against it. He's very hungry. Tim, I'm not feeding you again. I'm not going to feed you anything again. You got to make it to at least day 20, bro. Take care of ourselves. Yeah. The package outside, wrapped in so much crumpled newspaper, it's basically a shapeless blob, but a note attached says, "You're the man of the shelter, boy. Don't let us down. Dad, should we open it?" Oh, come on. Maybe those are supposed to be, like, just logic checks. I don't know. But that seems a little too easy to just dismiss. We're certain that this is some bandit ruse. So the package was left untouched outside. Best case scenario, it would contain a mutated tarantula. In water now. No. Dude, we've already been through this, Tim. Day 14, the trash can is becoming full of empty soup cans, and that unmentionable bucket is overflowing. Both of them are attracting strange glowing insects. Again, I don't know what I'm supposed to do about them. I've got no way of... You all can see what I've got. I've got nothing. Now we have cockroaches around here. Oh my, that thing is huge, and there goes another one. Roaches everywhere. We're doomed. We're already feel all dirty. It's day 15. We'll feed them halfway through. We'll surely be back soon. One of their biggest advantages is knowing they have the numbers, and they know it. What if we made them think we brought reinforcements? I don't know. I hear a knock at the door. And Timmy's sick. Great. We spent so long considering all the possibilities, we ended up doing nothing about it before the band showed up again. And show up they did. Fortunately, it sounded like these thugs lost their flashlight and couldn't find the bunker door in the dark of the night. They circled the perimeter for some time, shouting, being scanned by kindergartners before remembering that one of them is scared of the dark and giving up. Next time, we might not be so lucky. So now we've got to try to feed Timmy. Feed Timmy to good health. We have... How much food... How much do we have left? 1.251... Okay, so we have even amounts of food and even amounts of water. Water is going to be more important than food. There's no reason for us to keep the destroyed gun. Oh, I guess I can't sell that either. Guess the cards? No, we need water. But we can't get water! I guess the cards. We're not going to need them. I'd rather take the food, especially since we're going to have to nurse him back to health, hopefully. Halfway there, Timmy. Stay strong, bro. Yeah, I'm going to keep feeding Tim. Hopefully he gets better. Day 17, someone is very serious about banging on the hatch. We're scared to open it. Might be some good news. We gladly welcome a friendly face in your neighborhood. Shall we open it? It might be, this might be good. Or it could also end the run. Okay, it didn't end the run. Might be the doctor. Oh, it might be the doctors. Who was it, Tim? Someone started shooting at us. We closed the door. Oh, now Timmy's hurt. I don't know. I think this might be GG, team. Sure, I'll give him a drink too, just to see if it helps. So Timmy's hurt and he's sick. N19, although they're a bit glowy. Blah, 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 blah. We opened the bunker door this morning to let some fresh radioactive air in. We discovered a small suitcase at the door. There's a note on it. Neighborhoods. Should we take a look inside? Yeah, at this point, why not? If it's a bomb, then whatever. I mean, still coughing. I don't see anything new. Inside the suitcase, we found some soup, but yuck, it's expired a long time ago. We're not feeling very well, so some of it. I'm gonna spend the morning not accepting knobs gifts ever again. I'm gonna keep on feeding Timmy in hopes that he heals. Freezing cold outside. We have no cards. Yep. Nope, nope, that's it. Yeah. Well, there's Marv and I forget Joe Pesci's name. Didn't manage to protect our home. Okay, so let's see if I'm gonna do one more run here. That's interesting. I like these challenges. It's something short and easy and digestible there. I think that we can do it. I feel like we don't have to use the rifle at the early part of it, maybe. But again, I don't know how much Sinvicta luck is involved here as well. So we'll do that. We'll do one more run. I like that challenge. It seems like a good thing. All right, shelter alone instead of home alone. Okay. Here we go. Take two. But now we know what to expect. So I think that it's doable. I just want to make sure that if there is a whole lot of RNG, we need to make sure that we've got a handle. We have a padlock. Wait, is it random? Because now we have a map and a padlock, which was something we didn't have in that last run. Interesting. So there is a little bit of RNG already confirmed in the start here. I'm gonna choose not to use the gun this time. Okay, so it looks like day two is meant. Yeah. Okay, so it looks like day two is meant to be the gun sink. So you have to figure out ways. You have to figure out ways to not let the bandits in. But at the same time, I don't know how we're supposed to fight them off. Like if the game doesn't give us a chance, like maybe we should open one of those gifts. I guess. I don't know. We'll do one more run here since that one doesn't really count. I mean, come on. Like I'm going through the motions here, trying to figure out the logic behind what exactly is the true challenge here. So it looks like day two is guaranteed to take your gun no matter what. Which would make sense, unless that was just a pure coincidence, which I'm pretty sure it's not. Yeah, so now we don't have a map. We do have a radio now, though. Interesting. And we also have bullets. Oh, you know what? So bullets means that we don't have to we don't have to consume the gun now, because it shouldn't jam. So this shouldn't end with the gun being disabled. Nope, it's scripted. Okay. Fine. And he's already gone crazy, Timmy? Now, you know what? You didn't go crazy that entire run. Maybe the hunger will get the crazy out of him. There you go. All right. Drink on day five. Listen to the radio. Convinced that we have backup. Hopefully he didn't break the radio. He did not break the radio. We built a scarecrow outside using empty soup cans. Then we turned out what used to be a radio theater channel and put the volume on max. Luckily, something was still playing, probably an old recording set on a loop. Combination of a loud radio broadcast, a few cans dangling in the wind turned out to be terrifying. As soon as they approached, the band has turned back, screaming about monsters from Mars invading the Earth with heat rays. Really? As if the nuclear war wasn't enough. We're worried about Timmy's. Well. Every new smell. So hopefully this will always result in the can. I hear a new knock on the door. You not see any more food. And we lost the radio. Good job, Tim. Way to go. Galloping horse, no, and we don't have the map, so we can't help out the cosplayers. Oh boy, this one's looking rough here, team. Couldn't contain our laughter, blah, blah, blah. Cheers, Mary Jane. Wrapped what seems to be six different times of wrapping paper. Note says, Mom is making me write this. I hate you. Try not to die for whatever. Cheers, Mary Jane. Could be a bomb. At this point, Timmy's already crazy. We might as well see what we can get from these. I don't notice anything different. Oh, we have a harmonica. It was a real gift. Nothing toxic, radioactive, or explosive. What a pleasant surprise. Yeah, we never thought to see Dancing Cockroach. Yeah, so let's... I'm going to use the bug spray on the roaches because we still have bullets left. Hopefully that gets us some food. It did not. We dodged a bullet this time as if the bullet was huge, hairy, had eight legs and glowing head. Hopefully we don't have to deal with them again. Yeah, so Timmy needs everything now. That's fine. Day 10, these bandits are surely going to get in if we don't figure out a way to stop them. There's half-broken wall around the trap door leading to the shelter. If something very heavy was dropped there, it might be enough to knock out Invader 2. Sure. Use the briefcase, because that's all we've got. Timmy's still crazy. The suitcase was loaded with rocks, empty cans, and other junk and placed on top of a broken wall. With a piece of string as a tripwire, we got ourselves a functional booby trap. The bandits walked right into it, too. One was knocked out clean, and the other got an empty can stuck in his head. We could hear him bumping into things while he dragged his unconscious friend away. We hope we never see either of you jerks again, we shouted, for good measure. But we know they probably will. Weirder than usual, anyway. Okay. Yeah, so day 15 is when we can, open it at this point. Day 15 is when we can save Tim. So at least we can give him water. Okay, Timmy's sick now, but we got food and water. Turned out it was a nice, mysterious fellow in a weird suit. He gave us some soup cans. This should help us survive the next couple of days. Opening the hatch a bit risky. Okay, so Timmy's sick, but we got enough food. You're the man in the house, open it, sure. So it looks like those packages are kind of important. But they probably lead you to getting sick. And we got a briefcase. It was definitely a gift, not some cruel prank. How nice. Some tough love wouldn't do more harm than the A-bomb radioactive mutants. And okay, so... I'm going to keep feeding him. I'll give him water on day 15 if he lives that long. Come on, Tim. You can pull out of it. We decided we can get rid of the spiders with our bare feet and whatever. Turns out... Timmy is a bit crazy of a crazy kid, but a few more days and he will stay crazy for good. One more day, Tim, is all you need. I'm going to keep feeding you. One more day. Doesn't sound too good, Tim. Well, he's not dead. We decided to ignore any problems with the vents and focus on other problems as predicted. We developed nasty cough. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, so let's give Timmy everything here, day 15. It's freezing cold outside. The bands probably expect us to huddle in a corner with a blanket, so it's perfect time to stand up and fight. We need to set an effective trap. Is there any way we can use nuclear winter to our advantage? I'm not going to use water, so I'm going to use cards instead. The trap did nothing to stop the bandits. Maybe a different item could have done the trick here. Fortunately, it sounded like these thugs lost their flashlight, couldn't find the bunker door. And we can't sell anything, so no going there. Now, the problem is it looks like we're probably not going to have protection from the bandits. Unless somehow the harmonica can act as a trap. I think this is going to be it, team. Something's barely left untouched. Blah, blah, blah. Still sick. All right, I'm going to feed you again, Tim. We can sell the bullets in exchange for water. How much water do we have? We've got enough water. I'm going to keep the bullets just in case. And he's still sick. He's still crazy. A 19. In the inside of the office, Timmy's looking very pale. You give him water now. He can survive one more day. I'll finish off that bottle. There you go. Open in the name of freedom, came a shout from them. Probably kill someone in the name of freedom. Should we open? Yes, sure. Why not? We need all the help that we can get. Okay, 10 days out, Tim. We got a whole bunch of water, but not a lot of food. We regretted opening the door the minute we saw who was standing on the other side. Dark faces, rifles, determined looks, a band of teenagers. We're doomed, we thought. Then we turned out of the blue. One of them asked if we were with the Reds. We never supported the Red Sox, so we confidently say that we weren't. The tension was dropped immediately, and those nice young people gave us 2 bottles of water. They also told us have no fear since the Wolverines are around. We're not sure what the Wolverines have to do with all this, but we took their word for it. So Timmy got hooked up with a lot of water. I'm gonna give him water too, just to make sure that. Well, this is probably it right here. We have no way of stopping the bandits again. Yeah. Okay, so it looks like there is some RNG luck involved, especially with the start. Especially now that we know that the gun is always going to be taken away from you on day 2. So yeah, we can revisit this challenge another time. But again, thank you all very much for the support here on 60 Seconds Reatomized. And let me know if you want to go dive into more challenges here, or if you just want the standard runs. I personally prefer the runs right now, just because I want to see more of the I want to see more of the story and everything, and get all the variant scenes out of the way. But the challenges do kind of provide us with a nice little breakup of content and gameplay. So let me know in the comments down below. Thank you all very much for the support. Moch. Thank you all very much. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.